Welcome, everyone, to famed Sanford Stadium between the hedges in Athens, Georgia, home to the Bulldogs and 90,000 of their closest friends. But this contest is not a regular matchup, a battle of two top tens, two forces colliding, one team leaves here, making a resounding statement. As we'll see, the number six team in the country, the Texas Longhorns, taking on the second-ranked team, the Georgia Bulldogs. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, joined here in the booth by Kirk Herbstreit. Kirk, let's get to the action on the field. The Longhorns will kick it away to get this game going. He's going to return it from near the goal line. Stopped at the 22. That's pretty solid coverage there. So Georgia's offense making their way on the field to open this game. And here comes the tight end who's having such a great season. Kirk, you talk to opponents and they always use the same phrase, matchup nightmare.
Well, what stands out to me with this guy is it's not very often, you're right, that defensive coordinators are most concerned about a tight end. But in this case, that is exactly what we're dealing with. This guy can hurt you in so many different ways. Chris, this is what I'd love to see from a defense. Is the linebackers are scraping, doing their job, but you need help from the secondary. And when you have aggressive tacklers on the back end, you got a great defense. This time, the secondary makes the difference.
Looking downfield, it's Beck. Snags a quick throw. Finally out of bounds after a solid gain, but there is a flag on the field. So let's check this out. And the head coach will decide to accept the penalty and take the yardage. Same tailback, another carry. Just a small gain, looking at second and nine.
You know, in the era that we live in right now, everybody wants to spread the field around, try to create space, try to create one-on-one matchups, and the defense is countered over the years by trying to play out wide. But here's a great example. The defense has the ability to play wide, but still be solid at the line of scrimmage and not give up big run plays.
Fakes the handoff here, looking to throw it, looking for his big tight end. He pulls it in for a big gain. Explosive gain across midfield. They'll spot it about the 35.
Really good route here by the receiver, but I love the quarterback's ability to look off that safety and make that throw. And that's part of the quarterback's job here when you play in Athens for this Georgia offense. They've had some great quarterbacks over the years. Guys like Matthew Stafford and Aaron Murray and more recently Jake.
And he can't escape. It's a sack for the defense.
This is exactly how you can slow down the momentum and a rhythm of an offense. You got to get some tackles for a loss and some sacks. This time, they come up with a sack by getting after that quarterback.
So this offense faces a second and 15. The O-line needs to regroup. Play action fake, looking to throw. Pressure comes, and once again, no escape.
The defender did not bite on the fake at all. They were in pass rush mode the entire time.
After consecutive losses, they need a miracle here on third and a mile. Looking to throw, it's Beck. Looking to set up a screen pass here. Defense makes the stop. The screen pass doesn't produce a first down, and now it's fourth down.
Now there's just nothing here for the quarterback to do other than throw it to his back and hope that he could get the yards after the catch enough for the first down. But the defense gives some yards, but not enough for him to get to the sticks.
So out comes the field goal team from a long way out. They are putting a whole lot of faith in this kicker. And he's got it. Can you believe it? What a kick.
I was watching this guy in pregame. He has got a strong leg. I'm surprised here he's able to put 3 points up here for the offense.
So after coming away with three in that drive, the kickoff team is out. Returner looking to make a play here. To be tackled at the 17. Strong job by the coverage team. The Longhorns offense takes the field. Our first chance to see them today. And with such a dangerous wide receiver on the field here, puts a lot of stress in the secondary. This strong safety, Kirk, maybe not necessarily built as a great coverage guy, he's going to have to be big today.
Yeah, he really is, Chris. He's known for his physicality. This safety's going to have to do a good job of cleaning up tackles, but also being an extra guy to play keep away. He's good at doing both, but this receiver has great ball skills and the ability to break away with speed. Going to be a unique matchup to follow.
It's early, but this crowd is fired up. Listen to this noise here. This is going to be tough for the visitors today. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
Chris, I think we all kind of get caught up in third down. What's an offense doing on third down? But I think what's also important is how well you defend first down. If you can hold your opponents to a short gain or a tackle for a loss, you throw the offense out of whack, and their game plan gets much more challenging to try to come up with that first down.
And they hit him just as he releases the ball. It's incomplete.
Well, I'm a big fan of the RPO, but it is a dangerous play for the quarterback. You got to make the right decision. On this play, it just seemed like he was a little hesitant, unsure, and it cost him here with an incompletion.
Offense facing a third and long from the 28. Got to have your pass protection in order on this play. He's going for a big play downfield. Oh, incomplete. He's very lucky that wasn't intercepted here on the opening possession. I'd like to have that one back. It's going to bring up fourth down. The Longhorns will line up to kick it away. And the coverage team pins him in and brings him down. And the Bulldogs offense is back out on the field. They were fortunate to get points on the last possession because of a long-range field goal. Tries the right with a quick throw. It's complete. What a grab near the sideline. They bring him down, but the veteran quarterback shows off that trademark arm strength.
It's a great play for the offense, but let's give all the credit to the offensive line for that play. The quarterback makes the throw, but he couldn't have done it without the time that they provided.
Quick throw. That's an RPO caught on the left side. To get him down quickly, not much of a gain on that completion.
Well, anytime an offensive coordinator calls a wide receiver screen, he's trying to get offensive linemen out in front of the receiver to create a wall so that receiver can pick a lane to run through. How about the defense here, though? That's called team pursuit and swarming to the football. They didn't give him any lanes, so not much yards downfield for the receiver.
To throw, it's Beck. Catch hauled in here over the middle. They stop him, but it's a first down.
Boy, great slant by the receiver. What I love is the quarterback found the window that he wanted to make the accurate throw.
Georgia getting set with a first and 10 now. And here's the handoff. The gain is 2 yards, so it's second and 8.
With the defense coordinator this week already telling us about gap integrity, not giving this running back any creases at all. Really sound defense on that play.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Receiver in motion now. Looking to pass here on second down. Couldn't find anybody open and just has to throw it away. After the second down incompletion, they'll have to convert here on third down and 8. Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. Here's a wide open receiver, complete. finally brought down, but it's an explosive game ball all the way to the 21.
If I'm this defense, you get these guys to third down, you better bracket or double team some kind of coverage roll to this receiver to take him away. This guy makes another big play.
Offense set for the sixth play in this drive. Off the play fake, looking to throw on first down. The sure hands, it's Bell. They make the tackle, but it sets the offense up for a first and goal from the 10.
This offense has become a first down machine, and that's so demoralizing for a defense, especially for those star players who don't sub out as much. But the fourth quarter really starts to wear you out.
The Dogs line it up with first and goal. First and goal, handoff. That's a nice tackle there by the senior. That's a second and goal play for the offense. Trying for the end zone, running it right up the gut. Running toward the end zone, but the defense forces a fumble. Defense recovers the fumble. It's a turnover.
I get being upset at the ball carrier for coughing up the ball, but let's not ignore how big of a hit that was. Sometimes you just have to give credit to the defender for making a great play.
Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. The last drive, they came up empty, had to kick it away. Can they come up with something here? They go with the ground game here. Running back takes the handoff. Defense shoves him out of bounds. Not much of a gain there.
Coaches told us in the pregame production meetings they love this back's mixture of speed and power. We know about the speed, but he also showed the ability to break tackles on that run.
And wow, listen to this crowd noise. This stadium is vibrating. That's why this is such a tough place for visitors to play. Stopped short the marker after just a short gain. Interesting play call here. Third and short inside their own 20. They want to get this drive going, or a punt could give the opponents excellent field position. Dropping back, it's yours. Short throw complete to the tight end. He's tackled quickly, but the yardage is good enough for the first down.
Hey, I don't blame the defense here at all, Chris, for bringing the blitz. It's third down and short. You got to get pressure on the quarterback, but you got to tip your cap to this quarterback. I think he was anticipating the blitz, so he's able to get the ball out of his hands quickly and pick up the first down.
Play action here on first down. Quick throw to his receiver. Oh, and he fumbles. Defense has got the football.
You know, with wide receivers, we get enamored with their size and their speed and their versatility and their ability to make plays after the catch. But none of those things are more important than taking care of the ball. He makes the catch, but he doesn't secure the football, and it's a fumble.
They expect to cash in the starting field position. It is first and goal from the 2. And they're trying to punch it in here. And he runs it in for the score. Touchdown, Dogs! We had a short field. The offense did exactly what they're supposed to do. That would have been a big ask for the defense there.
Absolutely. But when you're given that kind of field position, anything less than a touchdown would be a disappointment. They did exactly what they needed to do by capitalizing on that short field.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with a PAT. And the kick is up and good. They tack on a point to their lead. The kickoff team on the field now is set to send this one away. Well, he thought about coming out, but instead takes a knee and will bring the football to the 25-yard line. The Longhorns offense takes the field. Last possession ended in a fumble, and that set up a touchdown. So they got to bounce back from that right away. They've got him at the 48, but that's a first down.
Boy, when you get a one-on-one opportunity, you got to cash in on it. And this Texas receiver makes a great play to be able to come up with a big gain. This defense cannot just load up on the run game and a quarterback and leave these receivers one-on-one.
Longhorns looking to crank up the tempo a bit. Looking for some space. It's Blue. They tackle him behind the line, a loss of four. Well, that was that excellent linebacker with a clear path just running downhill quickly.
You know, I think one of the great things about watching this guy play all year is his vision. He just has great instincts. That time, the defensive line ate up all the linemen, freed up the linebacker to get into the backfield, and the result is a tackle for a loss for the backer.
Makes a quick catch. Tackle finally made. That's a very solid gain, but not close to first down yardage.
We see this all over the country now in college football. Defensive backs staying a back a little bit deeper, forcing the quarterback to have to throw things in front. I like the decision here by the quarterback because he gets positive yards. It's a good way of staying ahead of the chains.
Back to throw. It's yours. Fires it to the wideout. Oh, and he dropped it. You don't see that often from this guy. Brings up fourth down. The Longhorns will bring their punt team onto the field. We're going to kick it away for the second time. And the punt lands out of bounds. Let's see exactly where they'll spot it here. And the Georgia offense is back out on the field. They punched it in the last possession. Can they do it again, or will this defense make some adjustments to get a stop?
I think that's on the quarterback and the offensive line. They were breathing down this quarterback's neck before he could even recognize that they were there, and they were able to knock it loose.
A chance to get right back into this football game. It's first down and goal. He'll try to muscle toward the end zone on the ground. Fights his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Longhorns. Well, they began with great field position, and that didn't take long at all, Kirk.
Well, that's how you take advantage of an opportunity. Your defense sets you up in great field position. You're not looking for a field goal. You're looking for a touchdown. Give the credit to this offense for being aggressive and punching it in.
And they'll set up for the PAT. The extra point is good. They trail by three now, 10-7.
That makes the score Georgia 10, Texas 7.
Kickoff team is on the field. Let's see if they give the returner a chance to bring this one back. And here's the return from inside the five. And he'll be tackled at the 27. That's where the drive will start. And the powerful Georgia offense is back out on the field. Looking to protect the football and protect the lead. They fumbled it away last time. That run moves the ball across the 35.
Great job by the offensive line here, opening up some holes and giving the running back room to run on first down. Plays like this can open up the playbook for the play caller, allow him to make that defense think, are they going to run? Maybe play action, maybe throw the ball downfield.
Second down after that run on the previous play. And there's the handoff. That's good for first down yardage. They'll spot it at the 37.
Well, great patience and acceleration to be able to pick up this first down by this back from Georgia. You think of Georgia backs, you think about Herschel Walker right away, right? Sonny Michel, Todd Gurley, Nick Chubb, Knowshon Moreno. I mean, the list goes on and on of great Georgia backs.
That run, good for a first down. The offense still rolling. Dropping back, it's Beck. And it's incomplete. The defender arrived the same time as the football. And now it's second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out the punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, he's unable to hold on to the football.
Incompletion makes it second down. And he'll set up to throw. It's an out route, the catch made. And a huge gain before he's forced out of bounds. Big yardage to set up a fresh set of downs.
Boy, huge play by this offense. A good throw, nice, accurate throw. But I think it's the run after the catch that really impresses me. And early in this game, you got to think they're going to continue to go back to him until this defense shows that they can slow him down.
The Dogs offense is on the move now. On first and 10, they'll look to throw it. Grab made by the tight end. And he's brought down, but he does have enough for the first down.
This defense has got to do a better job in coverage if they want to get off the field anytime soon. You keep defending like that, and this offense could have 50 on you by the end of this game.
Georgia setting up for the first and 10 now. Quarterback still with the football. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of two.
Oh, my gosh. Give this defense all the credit in the world. They had their eyes in the right position playing assignment football. Quarterback just looking for daylight. Couldn't find anywhere to go there on the keeper on the option. Again, that's great assignment football by the defense.
Offense getting set. It's second down. Fakes the handoff. Looking to throw. And the quarterback finds the tight end for the completion. And he's shoved out of bounds with the defense short of the first down marker.
This is why running the football is so important. You run the ball and then you go play action. It affects the eyes of the safeties and linebackers and frees up some space for the tight end to be able to pick up a nice game.
So here we go. Third down in the red zone. The kind of play that decides football games. No, and he dropped it. The would-be touchdown could not come up with the football. Now it's fourth down.
Hey, the good news is here, Chris, they're still in field goal range, and they didn't cost themselves any points. But they could have more. They've got to be thinking about going for this on fourth and short.
So on fourth down now, out comes the field goal unit. The field goal is good.
Well, they almost put a touchdown on the board, but instead they come away with 3 points.
Following the field goal, the kickoff team is out there now. And he'll lead the kickoff right there. We'll start from the 25. Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. Great possession last time. They punch it into the end zone. Can the defense come up with a stop this time? They'll bring him down right at the 30-yard line.
I think this defense keeps thinking about them throwing the football, and by doing that, they're opening up running lanes. Good positive yards there by the running back.
The game makes it second and medium. Here comes a handoff. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that.
That back just had nowhere to go. Got to give credit to the defense and their run fits on that play.
Critical third down play for this offense right here. Off play action. He's looking to throw. Caught over the middle. It's Helm. They've got him, but not before he makes a first down at the 41.
That's a great play by this offense to keep the drive alive, and a good find by the quarterback on third down.
The clock is running last minute in a very entertaining first quarter of play. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Going for a big play downfield. Deep ball is caught for a huge gain here.
Chris, what a play here by this receiver for a big gain for Texas. And you think back over the years with Texas going back decades, I always think about running backs and, of course, quarterbacks, but there have been some receivers, Roy Williams and Devin Duvernay, guys like that. There have been others, but, man, plays like this, this is what you love to see and kind of creating that new legacy for Texas of having elite receivers.
Offense will keep it on the ground here. And the senior able to make the stop after a short gain.
Gain of two. Second down.
We've had a good early quarterback duel so far, Kirk. Let's check out the stats.
Georgia, 13, Texas, 7.
They've flipped into the field. We're ready now for the second period. Offense getting set up. Here's second down. Looking to throw. It's yours. He launches too high, out of bounds, and incomplete.
You know, the game often comes down to a play or two, and the offense just missed a huge opportunity for a big play. They're going to have to make some adjustments there, maybe go back to that play and see if they can come up with a big opportunity.
After the second down incompletion, they'll have to convert here on third down and eight. Dropping back, we're going to throw for the first down. Fires it to the wideout. Grab down the middle, it's Bond. The tackle is made, but the offense is now set up with a first and goal from the eight.
And you just continue to see the chemistry between these two. And they told us yesterday in our production meeting, they spent hours and hours of working and developing that chemistry and that rhythm by throwing together throughout those summer months. And man, it's starting to really pay off. He's become his security blanket for the quarterback, and especially on third down, get him the ball.
Keep it on the ground on first and goal. Couldn't quite get there, but brought down at the one-yard line.
Well, let's give credit to the offensive line here. They went with a run blitz. The offensive line sees it, picks it up, gives them enough room to pick up some solid yards.
Solid gain puts them in good position for second down and goal. On the ground, trying to power toward the goal line. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Texas. Sam Bam Cunningham, Bo Jackson. That's a play that legendary running backs have made.
Man, let's not forget Herschel Walker. Yeah, it's right. You're thinking of old school running backs. It's very rare to see backs go up and over at the goal line. It's refreshing. Nice to see.
And now the try here for the extra point. And the PAT is good. It puts them in front, 14-13 now.
That makes the score. Texas, 14, Georgia.
Now they get set to kick it away.
Number 15, set to kick this one away.
Bringing it out, it's Bell. Makes it to the 16. That's good coverage there. And the Bulldogs offense is back out on the field. They moved it last time, but settled for a chip shot, looking to find the end zone this time. Oh, what a move. Oh, what a move. Goes right through the tackle. He's got room to run now. Oh, and he breaks free. It's a foot race. And he takes it all the way to the end zone. Touchdown, Bulldogs.
Oh, my. What a great play call here by the offensive coordinator. The running back received some great blocking up front and just took off with it, carving up this defense all the way to the end zone.
Here comes the point after attempt. The extra point makes the lead six. Now the kickoff team is out on the field. Returner looking to create better field position. And the coverage team able to bring him down. The Longhorns offense takes the field. A little bit of my turn, your turn in the early going here. Both offenses scoring touchdowns their last possession. They make the tackle, but that pass creates a solid gain.
One thing I love about this back is how he gets involved in the passing game. Nice catch here.
Second down after that run on the previous play. The shotgun running play call. That's a nice tackle there by the senior.
Christian, the spread era over the years has always grown offensively, but I've been always impressed with the defenses that really build their defense to play in space still have an ability to be sound at the line of scrimmage and defend a running game. It's exactly what we saw right there.
Crucial third down play right here. Off the play fake, looking to throw the football. And he decides to just throw it away. That's going to bring up fourth down now.
Man, on your own side of the field, you're playing a risky game here. Third and short. Your goal should just be keep this drive alive the best way you can. Sometimes is just hand the ball off to your running back and have him get behind that offensive line and go to work. Curious to see what they do now here on this fourth and short.
They bring the rush, but he gets it away. He'll be brought down, but a penalty marker is on the field. Let's see what this is about.
Personal foul. Roughing the kicker.
Defense. Pretty easy call for the head coach. He will accept that penalty, of course. Offense gets a second chance after the roughing the punter penalty. To throw, it's yours. Looking for the wideout. Catch made down the left side, an explosive play. They stop him at the 49, but that'll be a first down.
Whew, that was pretty. The receiver broke down his defender on that curl against man-to-man coverage. That's how you win one-on-ones.
Longhorns have first and 10 here. Shotgun formation. Here's an inside handoff.
It's exactly what you want to see as a play caller. You get positive yards to be able to kind of keep you on schedule as a play caller. That's all you can ask for. Good job up front and a nice run.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Play action fake, looking to throw. And the pass is complete to the tight end. A huge hit by the linebacker. A collision of big bodies there.
Just a good job of spreading the wealth, making sure everybody's getting their touches. When you do that, the defense can't lock in on one guy or two guys. Make them have to be aware of everybody and allows you to continue to spread the ball around and spread the field, making it tougher for this defense.
And moves the ball to the 35 and another first down.
You know, offensive linemen are just a certain breed. They're always going to do their job, no matter who's back there carrying the ball. I tell you what, they have a little bit more confidence when the person that's carrying the ball can break off some big-time runs. That makes them block just a little bit harder, knowing what he's potentially capable of doing.
Looking right, this one caught. They bring him down, but that's a solid gain on the play.
Well, this is what coaches love to see. A quarterback with the ability to read the defense properly and then just get it to the open man. Sometimes it sounds simple, but it's tough to execute. This time we have good recognition by the quarterback, and he gets it down to the tight end. You can see what he can do after the catch.
Offense sets up for play number 8 on this drive. He's brought down after a short gain. That's not going to be first down yardage.
Hey, they get some positive yards here, but just from sitting up here looking down, Chris, I kind of have a sense that they wanted a little bit more on that play.
Important second down play coming up. The offense with some pre-snap motion. Gonna run it. It's blue. And that run produces a decent gain.
Just love watching this back run. Gets behind that offensive line, lowers his pads, and gets a nice, solid game.
A And here comes the noise. This crowd is trying to inspire this defense to make a big red zone stop. They'll try to run for the first down. Tackled, but only after picking up a fresh set of downs.
Here's a great example of a back knowing where he needed to go on this play, and he didn't mess around. He got between the tackles and earned every single yard.
Fans of the defense got to be frustrated. The offense cannot be stopped here. Moving the receiver around pre-snap. They'll switch it up, looking to throw. Got him, he's sacked.
Well, you got to do a better job with your fake as the quarterback. The defense did not bite at all in the play action, allowing them to continue to come after the quarterback and come up with that sack.
That sack sets up a second down and long. And the ball is handed off out of the shotgun. The junior able to bring him down quickly.
See, that's how you limit what an offense wants to do. This time, the defense just won the battle up front at the line of scrimmage, not giving up any big plays. Everybody's gap sound. It's really solid defense on that play.
And the drive that will not end, it is a long way to go on third down here. Back to pass. It's yours. Launching one to the end zone. Oh, and it's batted down by the defense. Great play to deny a touchdown.
Hey, it's an incompletion, but it's a nice job by the quarterback. I know it didn't pan out, but the most important thing is he didn't turn the football over and he didn't take a sack. It'll give your kicker a chance to put some points on the board if they opt for the field goal here on fourth down.
So here on fourth down, out comes the field goal team. He knocks this one right through.
Oh, Chris, it's a nice kick here to polish off that drive with at least 3 points up on the board.
They come away with 3 points on the drive, and now the kickoff team will boot it away. Fields it just outside the goal line. And he stopped at the 20, tried to make something happen, but that's good coverage there. And the Georgia offense is back out on the field. The last possession was a one-play touchdown drive on the ground. See if the offensive line can continue to create some big lanes. Near the sticks, it's Young. And they'll move the sticks on that one. It's a first down at the 42.
Just a really good ball here to be able to pick up this first down for the Georgia offense. And, you know, being able to have a balanced attack, so important in modern college football, and Georgia does that as well as anybody.
So one play moves the ball to the 42-yard line. It'll be first down. And they're moving the receiver now before the snap. Throws to the tight end. But they can't make the connection. Ball's incomplete.
Well, they don't make the completion here. The timing seemed to be off between a quarterback and the receiver. But, man, this defensive coordinator, he may want to consider getting more pressure on this quarterback by changing some things up. He's got a lot of time back there to throw the ball. And eventually, that's going to cost you.
Second down after that previous play. And he's back to throw again after that incompletion on first down. Incomplete. Very lucky to avoid an interception there.
Pretty nice catch here, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, but hands, sometimes a little questionable, as we saw here.
Had the big play to start the drive, but now, after two incompletions, they face a third and 10. Looking to throw yet again. Delivers quickly to the left side. He's got an open man downfield, and it's caught. Touchdown, Georgia. Strong game by this quarterback.
Such a well-designed play here by this offense to find a way to get the ball to the gifted tight end. He's got the size, he's got the speed, he's a difficult matchup, and here he shows he's got the speed to take it all the way into the end zone for that touchdown.
And now here comes the point after attempt. The extra point is good, and they stretch the lead a little bit more. Kickoff team has come on the field now to send this one away. So no return here. He takes it in the end zone, and they'll begin the drive at the 25. Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. This is not the time to settle for field goals. They've got to find the end zone here. Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there.
Well, the back just had nowhere to go. How about the defensive line? They eat up all the blocks up front, freeing those linebackers up to be able to make the play. Just a bad play all around for this offense.
After the first down loss, it's second and long from the 22. Looking for a gap, it's Blue. Solid run. They'll bring it down to the 28-yard line.
It's not a huge game here, but if you add up multiple runs like that throughout the course of a game, by the fourth quarter, you're going to start to see that affect the defense.
Offense facing a third and long from the 28. Got to have your pass protection in order on this play. Defense able to stop it. It's fourth down now.
Chris, great effort here by this defense to keep him short of the first down. Now they've got a tough decision to make here on this fourth down and short.
Longhorns will bring their punt team on the field now. Bringing it back, it's Evans. And the returner is tackled by this punt coverage team. And the powerful Georgia offense is back out on the field. They punched it into the end zone the last time. Let's see if this defense has made some adjustments to stop them this time. Makes a quick grab.
Boy, that's pretty good coverage here by this defense. Not much of a window to throw this ball into, but the quarterback's accuracy and the size of the tight end picks up a nice game.
Completion sets up a second down play. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw it. Looks to the left, and it's complete. An explosive play. Big gain across midfield to the 42.
The defense is spread all over the field, creating some one-on-one matchups, and the quarterback makes them pay for it.
Big chunk play. This offense operating at peak efficiency. Motion by the back. Defense better adjust. Caught over the middle. It's Lovin. They get him down, but not before he moves the football to a 32.
Yeah, you know this defense has got to be frustrated after giving up multiple conversions now on first downs. There's another one. But for the offense, man, they're just playing very efficiently right now.
Georgia getting set with a first and 10 now. From the shotgun now, here's a handoff inside. Breaks one tackle, gets brought down, but picks up some decent yardage.
Chris, it's the consistency of this back is giving this defense fits. They've got to come up with some changes up front. This guy's already over 50 yards, and if he keeps running the way he is, not only is he having a great day, but it's going to give this quarterback a chance to hit some big plays downfield off play action.
Motion now from the tight end. Scanning the field. It's Beck. That one falls incomplete. Looking for a flag. Doesn't get it. Brings up third down.
Chris, I thought he had his hands on that football. I thought he was going to come down with it. But give the defense all the credit with a big hit to knock that ball loose.
So now it's third and short from the plus 24. Could be four down territory. Interesting to see what the call is here. Off the RPO, caught to the right. Got space, looking to score. Touchdown, Dogs! This quarterback on fire today. So the offense clicking now, Kirk, building the lead, and this one could get out of hand.
Well, it's just complete domination. The offense is executing and doing their job, putting points on the board. The defense has shown up prepared, ready to play. It just feels like this game's getting sideways in a hurry.
Lining up to try the extra point. Extra point makes it a 17-point game. Getting set to kick the ball off now. He'll return it from inside the five. And the returner will be brought down. The Longhorns offense takes the field. They were held to a quick three and out last time, looking to put together a positive drive here. He's tackled just short of the 20-yard line.
Nice job here of controlling the line of scrimmage by this offensive line. The back does what he needs to do to get positive yards on first down.
Again, makes it second and medium. Pre-snap motion from the receiver. Using his legs, it's Blue. And they'll tackle him about the 23-yard line.
When you can get good chunks of yardage like this on early downs, it just keeps you on schedule, leading to more manageable third down situations. Never underestimate the value of consistently getting four more yards a pop like that.
It's third down for the offense. Grab behind the line. It's Golden. And he'll head out of bounds, but not before picking up enough for a first down.
Well, it's third down. The defense knows he's going to get the ball. You still can't stop the quarterback finding this receiver to be able to pick up another first down for this offense.
Here's a first and 10 play. Easy throw to a wide open receiver downfield. The tackle is made, but there's a flag on the field. See what that's about. And the head coach will decide to accept the penalty and take the yardage. Out of the shotgun, he hands it off. They tackle him behind the line, a loss of four.
Well, I don't think the offensive line gave the back much of a chance at all. Now, give credit to the defense. It was almost like they were anticipating a run and got up close to the line of scrimmage in a hurry.
That's the two-minute warning. Let's see if this offense can do something before the break to cut into this big lead. Second down play coming up. Looking to pass. It's yours. Goes to his right side there for the completion. Timeout is called by the defense. That's their first of the half.
Hey, it's a game, but you get the sense that this offense wanted a little bit more from that play.
From the shotgun, it's a handoff. He's stopped short of the marker until it's fourth down now. And now a timeout quickly called by the defense as they try to get everybody on the same page here. The Longhorns will have to kick it away. That's his fourth punt already today. And the coverage team makes the stop on this return. This line getting set up. It's a first down play. Looking out throwing here to start the drive. And he finds a wide open receiver. They forgot about him downfield. Tackle made quickly, but a big chunk play for this offense through the air.
Boy, nice job here by this offense, creating an opportunity for this receiver to excel after the catch. It's early in this game, so this defense better get their arms around this receiver because he could be a monster today.
Linebackers making some adjustments now. Fresh set of downs for the offense after that first down completion. Send the back in motion. First down, looking to throw the ball. Grab down the middle. It's Bell. And they get him down after the completion.
One thing we know for sure, I don't know if as a play caller, you can make that call without a quarterback who can throw it with a big arm. He put that on a rope.
Pass caught, second down now. Quarterback drops back. We're going to test the secondary. It's a quick grab. He'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. This is turning into a monster day for this quarterback, Kirk. His passing yards now up over 350.
Yeah, and it seems like this defense has tried everything. They're blitzing. They're sitting back in zone. They're trying to double coverage certain receivers. Everything that they've tried is, unfortunately for them, not working because of how well this quarterback is seeing it and throwing today.
From the pocket, delivers over the middle. Tackled after the completion. Offense will now set up inside the five.
Boy, he has such great size. I just love this play call on first and 10. The defense is expecting a run. Instead, you go play action and you throw it to the big man for some positive yards on first and 10.
Dropping back, it's Beck. Looking for six, and it's picked off in the end zone.
When you get this close to the end zone, you've got to be able to come away with points, at the very least, a field goal. They got to be scratching their heads and hoping that in the second half, this play right here doesn't come back to bite them.
The offense comes back out there. Not much time left. Perhaps just time for a couple plays before the half. Takes the handoff. It's Blue. Oh, look at the quick cut. So a timeout is called. Just a few seconds left here in the first half. Looks like the final play of the half coming up. Second down, we're going to throw it. Grab near the sticks. It's Helm. And a big game before he goes out of bounds. The offense keeps churning, gets a fresh set of downs. And that will do it for the first half here. Kevin Connors now has our halftime update.
Guys, time for everyone inside that stadium in Athens to take a deep breath and kind of digest what we just saw. And if you thought that was a quick first half, you'd be right on the money. An offensive showcase, yes, but it's been those dynamic running backs who have set the pace. I'm curious to find out if this ground and pound approach is going to continue into the second half, or if one of those defenses will actually show some pride. It's time to throw it back to our guys in the booth to start up the second half.
We'll kick this away to begin the second half. Fields it inside the five-yard line. Returner brought down. Sets up the next drive. Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. And the wideout goes in motion. And he heads out of bounds after gaining a few yards.
Just a good job here by the quarterback. Got the ball out to his receiver. His guy eats up some yards. They stay ahead of the sticks.
The Longhorns will come to the line to run the hurry up. Movement here from the tight end. Dropping back. It's Ewers. Let's it fly out of the wideout. And he pulls in the catch. Solid gain there. Moves the ball out to the 32.
Well, it's a big risk to play man-to-man coverage by this defense, and this time they get caught. Great timing between the quarterback and his receiver. You can see what can happen when that timing is right. Big things can happen.
Big guys up front lined up. It's first down. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Down goes the quarterback. It's a sack.
Boy, what an incredible push by this defensive line. And if you're going to survive in the SEC, the teams that really separate themselves are the teams that have great defensive linemen, especially in the interior. And Georgia has had an incredible legacy over the years. And it's nice to see that this player right here is trying to live up to that.
That sack sets up a second down and very long. From the shotgun, drops back, looking for an open man.
Caught quickly.
They bring him down. That's a very solid game, but still well short of the first down.
Love the timing here between the quarterback and his receiver. Pick up some positive yards, and I continue to be impressed with just the chemistry between these two.
Hunter has been very busy so far. Can they finally convert here on third down? Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. Finds a man open on the right side downfield. Tackled across midfield at the 48, good enough for a first down.
This is a big conversion by this offense. They're down now in the second half. Probably limited opportunities at this point in the game. Every chance you get your hands on the ball, you need points. They keep this drive alive right here.
Longhorns looking to keep this drive rolling. Handoff here from the shotgun. And the tackle is made after a four-yard gain, so second and six.
Nice solid run here by this back. Did a nice job of just kind of finding that lane, pick up some positive yards there on first and ten.
A gain makes it second and medium. Quick throw caught on the left side. They bring him down, but that gain moves the ball all the way to the 31.
You know, we talked this week with the offensive coordinator about what makes this receiver so special. He kept referring to his route running. Here's an example of that. Great route, enough separation to give the quarterback a nice lane to throw the football.
The Longhorns looking to use the up-tempo offense here. Off the play fake on first down. Looks downfield and finds a receiver who worked his way wide open. Tackle is made at the 8-yard line. It'll be first and goal right there.
I really like the throw here, Chris, but the fake off the play action was just as effective. You saw the second level defenders freeze for a split second, and that helps open those passing windows.
Longhorns trying to punch it in. It's first and goal. They'll try to run it in on first and goal. He'll make it into the end zone. Touchdown, Longhorns.
Man, it's just a thing of beauty to watch this offense. That's this guy's third touchdown. But give the offensive line a lot of credit. They're getting enough of a push to give him some room to show you what he can do with that space.
Here's the point after attempt.
The kicker is on for the extra point.
PAT up and good. They get a little bit closer.
That makes the score. Georgia 34, Texas.
Kickoff team on the field getting set now.
Number 15 set to kick this one away.
And he takes this from inside the five. He'll be tackled at the 18. That's good coverage there. And the Bulldogs offense is back out on the field. They had some good things going on the last drive, but it ended suddenly with the pick. Let's see what they can do here. Looking for his big tight end. Looks downfield and connects with a wide open wide receiver. That gain is good enough for a first down. Ball spotted at the 42. So off the play fake there, the big tight end gets open downfield.
Well, I love this call right here. Anytime you can run the football, eventually it opens up play action. Linebackers and safeties' eyes are in the backfield. They lose the tight end completely, and a quarterback throws that one on rhythm for a nice game.
On first down, it's play action. Looks to the left for a quick throw. Physical defending. That one falls incomplete. Brings up second down.
scanning the field. It's Beck. And this pass is caught. They get him down, but the game moves the ball to the plus 40. Tackle made, but a strong arm throw by the senior quarterback.
You talk about a dream football game at the college level. This guy's now over 400 yards passing today.
Georgia setting up with a first and 10 now. Back to throw again. The pocket breaking down. And he just throws the ball away there. Nobody open. Excellent coverage. Incomplete. Second down coming up. Offense moving receivers around now before the snap. Fakes the handoff here, looking to throw it. Caught over the middle. It's Bell. And they tackle him, but not before he picks up the first.
You know, this is what makes this receiver so dangerous. If you play him in man, he can run by you for a big play. You decide to sit back in zone, and he's got the savvy and instincts to be able to find that soft spot in the zone, make a catch, and be dangerous after the catch as well.
Looking to throw it on first down. And he finds his tight end for the catch. But a huge hit by the linebacker. What a tackle.
That's a good job here, staying ahead of the chains. Good pickup here on first down. The quarterback hits the safety valve that time. The big tight end. That'll bring up a second manageable here for this offense.
Here comes a crucial second down play. Every yard tough to find down here in the red zone. Off an RPO, the quarterback looks to his right. Doesn't quite get in, but it sets up a first and goal for this offense. Just checking the stats after that last completion. He's approaching 450 passing yards now.
Boy, this guy's doing everything right to be able to have a day like this. He drops back, he finds these open receivers, and he puts the ball right on the money. And how about the receivers, the job that they've done being able to make plays after the catch today?
And the junior gets home, making a sack there.
Chris, let's tip our cap to this quarterback. He has gotten hit. That's the fourth sack already in this football game. Now, he's thrown for a lot of yards, so it's been one of those cases where either our band is playing or your band is playing. One way or another, you're getting a lot of fireworks in this game.
So from the 9-yard line, it's second and goal. Pre-snap motion from the offense. Hand off inside, looking for the touchdown. He's swarmed by the defense.
Boy, Chris, the way this quarterback's been playing, I'm surprised they didn't throw the football here. I wouldn't be surprised now that they're facing third down and goal, put it in his hands and let him work his magic.
Game sets up a third down and goal from the 6. Back to throw. It's Beck. Looking to the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Bulldogs.
Chris, remember in college football, it's just 1 foot down to be able to count for a touchdown. Does a great job towards the back line there. Doesn't go out of bounds. Goes up into the air and gets that 1 foot down. That's good. That's a score.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. And the PAT puts them up 17 now. Here's the kickoff team now, set to boot this one away. And so it'll be a touchback, ball spotted at the 25. The Longhorns offense takes the field. Off the play fake, looking to throw on first down. Oh, they've got him for a sack. A big play made by the junior.
Boy, great job here by this defensive lineman from Georgia using his hands and his speed to close in on the quarterback and come up with this sack. And, man, they've had some great ones over the years, Chris. As you know, starting with our guy, David Pollack, who had as good a career in his time in Athens as anybody who's ever put on that uniform. Richard Seymour, a brilliant career with the Patriots, but it all started in Athens. Jalen Carter, just an enforcer up front. And I even throw in Geno Atkins, who had a great career in the interior of that Georgia defensive line.
There's the handoff. And just a short gain this time, they're able to get him down. Looks like a man is down on the field after the last play, so we'll take a timeout. Third down, the offense desperately needs a conversion here, trailing in the third quarter. To the air, it's yours. He's looking deep here. And he is wide open for a huge gain. Oh, and nothing but green grass ahead. Touchdown, Texas. This offense really clicking.
This guy can do it all. We've seen him go behind coverage and make plays downfield. We can see him catch the ball underneath, just like this. And when he catches a football, he is so dangerous after the catch. This one leads him into the end zone for the 6 points.
Now the try here for the extra point. PAT is good. They still trail, though.
That makes the score Georgia 41, Texas 31.
Here's the kickoff team. Let's see if they give the returner an opportunity to bring this back. Return starts from inside the five. Solid job by the coverage team. They bring him down at the 16. And the Georgia offense is back out on the field. The last possession, they really had the passing game clicking. Move right down the field for a touchdown. Quick completion to the tight end. And he's out of bounds after gaining decent yardage.
And here the tight end shows off his hands for a nice game. Love to see the big man get his touches.
Completion makes it second and short. That's the wide receiver coming in motion now. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. They'll actually lose yardage after the catch. The defense all over him that time.
Well, that's one of those plays that works better against certain defensive looks, but not every defense is the same. They were all over that one. Let's see if they continue to tack to the outside on the perimeter to set something up downfield.
So the offense getting set. This is not where you want to be against this defense. Third and long. Grab down the middle. It's Lovett. Look at the speed there. They finally bring him down, but it's a nice gain.
Well, this offensive line, you got to tip your cap. They've done everything you would ask of them in taking care of this quarterback. They do it again here on third down, working with that lead. You know the pressure's coming, and they deliver.
Georgia getting set with a first and 10 now. Receiver in motion now. Play action here on first down. Looking for his big tight end. Oh, downfield catch made on the left side. Big gain across midfield. They'll spot it down near the 30.
What a pitch and catch by the quarterback and receiver for a big gain for this offense.
The Bulldogs pick up enough for a first down. Play action fake, looking to throw. It's a short completion of the tight end. They bring him down after a short gain there.
And there's the tight end who shows off his hands.
Second down after that completion. Looking to pass, it's Beck. Snags a quick throw. At the second effort, he's brought down, but he's past the marker.
Nice play-action call here by this offensive coordinator. You know, you can freeze those linebackers just for a split second. Usually that's going to give you enough room to be able to get that tight end behind them. And if the quarterback can make a nice tight throw like this, pick up some big yards.
Again, thrown out of the RPO, and it's complete. Big man finally brought down by the cornerback. That was a tough assignment. So down here in the red zone, every yard tough to find. Here is a crucial play coming up. Moving the receiver around pre-snap. They'll hand it off. That's a nice wrap up there by the junior. Offense facing a third down now. They can still get a first down without scoring. Quarterback in the shotgun here on third down. Caught near the goal line. And he can't quite get in. They get him down at the one-yard line.
Boy, this quarterback is unflappable. Here they are working with the lead in the second half. Get to a third down. You got to throw the football. This is where you trust the quarterback to make a good decision, an accurate throw. He does it. You convert, and you keep working that clock.
The Dogs looking to punch it in here. It's first and goal. Quarterback looking to connect with the receiver here. Defense is coming after him. And he just throws it away there. Safe move. And nobody open. Second and goal for the offense. On the ground, trying to muscle it across the line. They tackle him behind the line, a loss of four.
What a great job here by the defense, reading that play, pursuing to the football. Nice loss of yardage there on second and goal, and now it's third and goal for the offense.
Here we go, third and goal coming up. Looking downfield, it's Beck. Launching one to the end zone. And it's caught. Touchdown, Georgia. That's another strike from this quarterback, Kirk. He is having himself a day.
This guy's just having one of those days you dream about against this secondary. Let's also give credit to the wide receivers doing a nice job of getting open and the big fellas up front for giving him enough time to throw.
And they'll set up now for the extra point try. Extra point makes it a 17-point game. Kickoff team is on the field to boot this one away. And it comes out of the 25. No return attempted there. Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. Off the play fake, looking to throw. That's caught. It's Golden.
Well, defense didn't have any time at all to get pressure on the quarterback. He gets the ball out of his hands pretty quickly on the hitch to the receiver. Second down coming up.
A completion makes it second and short. Quarterback sets up, looking for an open man. Quick throw complete to the tight end. And the gain is good enough for a first down near the 38.
Chris, we get so caught up in these wide receivers and their playmaking ability and getting them the ball in space. And, right, the defense has to pay attention to them. Often too much attention opens up an underneath drag route like this, and quarterback makes a good read. Nice first down.
They're going to run it here. The gain is 3 yards, so second and seven.
Hey, listen, you don't always have to have big plays to be successful. It's a nice, solid gain here. Keeps you on schedule, and you get ready for that next play.
Offense getting set. Second down play here. And they're moving the receiver now before the snap. Looking for a gap. It's Blue. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
Things just appeared to be a bit out of sync from the get-go on that one. Give credit to the front seven of that defense for staying in the proper lanes and getting to the ball carrier, not let him dance around and make something out of nothing.
They punted four times already on the verge of a fifth. They can't convert this third down. Back to pass. It's Ewers. Quarterback finds an open target on the left side. Not much after the catch, but it is good enough for a first down.
Really good job here of converting by this offense. And let's face it, at this point in the game, because they have such a big hole to climb out of, they've got to be able to convert and come up with a new set of downs. They do it here. Now they got a real shot to cut into this lead.
Tight end goes in motion. Off the play fake on first down. He'll take a deep shot. And that deep shot is caught for a big gain. He makes the tackle, but he gains enough to make the first down and what should be the last play of the third quarter. And notice how the balance of this passing game has been on display here. A whole bunch of guys getting involved, catching passes. That's tough to stop. And now entering the final period of play, is there an epic comeback in store? We're going to find out. Caught in the backfield. It's Moore.
This is an example of a quarterback and his offense just taking what the defense gives you. Not a huge play, but positive yards. The defense wants to give that throw to you. You take it, get the ball to your receiver, stay ahead of the sticks.
So here comes second down now. Every play important down here in the red zone. Pre-snap motion from the receiver. Out of the shotgun, he'll hand it off. Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there.
That's a great play all around by this defense. Your first-level defenders hold their own at the point of attack, allowing the second- and third-level players to roam free and make the tackle close to the line of scrimmage.
They're backed up here, trying to make something happen on third and long. And now the handoff. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
Boy, nice job by this defense being able to diagnose the counterplay. You know, when you run that counter, you're hoping the illusion of the offense going one way and then coming back the other, that the defense buys into it. But they didn't buy it at all here, and they come up with a nice loss.
So here comes the kicking team on the field. They'll settle for three. He was on target the first time. Can he keep it going from 33 yards out? Kick is good. Gives the offense 3 points to show for that drive.
Snap, the hold, the kick, everything there perfect to put 3 points up here for the offense.
So after the field goal, the kicker out there again to boot it away. And it's Field, the returner, trying to create good field position here. Tackled at the 22. Good job by the coverage team. And the powerful Georgia offense is back out on the field. They take the field with serious momentum. They have been tough to stop so far. Can they keep it going? Throws to the tight end. Oh, nice play by the defender. Got a hand in there to break up the pass.
Some players just have a real knack for timing their jump, and that defender was able to get a big paw on the ball and bat it away.
Incompletion sets up a second down. To the air, it's Beck. And he's got his man open downfield. And the game just good enough for a first down.
Chris, it's another nice pickup through the air. I thought they might be really just out to run the football here with the lead. But instead, they're electing to throw the football. Different routes, quarterbacks in rhythm. Really, it's almost an extension of their passing game.
On first and 10 here, looking to throw the ball. Makes the catch downfield. Marked out of bounds, but it's another big game. This air attack, no problem moving the ball up and down the field today.
I mean, Chris, look at this guy. I mean, you talk about having a great day throwing the football and leading his team to a nice, comfortable lead late in the game, and it continues. The coach is showing confidence of what he can do.
Georgia setting up with a first and 10 now. Tight end goes in motion before the snap. Thrown quickly, caught in the right flat. Defense reacts quickly, a very short gain on the play.
How about this defense? That is called team pursuit, swarming to this wide receiver on the screen, not allowing him to get his momentum upfield.
Second down after that run on the previous play. On the run, it's ETN. The senior able to make the stop after a short gain. Wideouts now clustered. Third down play here out of the shotgun. Caught over the middle. It's Young. Takes the football inside the 30. And that's a first down.
Well, he's been their go-to guy all game long. They needed a big play there on third down. They go his way again, and it works out.
First and 10 now for the offense. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Here's a wide open receiver, complete. Tackle made after a nice pickup on the play.
I just continue to be in awe of this offense. Even with the lead, these guys are going to play for 60 minutes. They do not let up. Here they are. Typically, you'd want to run the football here to work the clock, but these guys stick to the game plan and keep throwing the football, trying to get more yards.
And they'll give it to the back. He stopped just short of that first down marker, inches away from it.
Now you're starting to see this defense, I think, wear down now that we're in the fourth quarter. It's been a tough day for them, and the offense is taking advantage of it. A lot of positive plays. Good job of eating as much clock as they can here on this drive in the fourth quarter.
Here comes a crucial second down play. Every yard tough to find down here in the red zone. And the quarterback keeps it on the option. And they'll tackle him for a loss of 5 yards.
Well, the quarterback does everything right except pitch the football. The defensive end's going to take him, which is great. That's what you want. But you got to get that ball out quicker to not allow that defensive end to make that play.
An important third down conversion coming here in the red zone. To throw, it's Beck. Looking to the end zone. The pass is incomplete just across the goal line.
Interesting call here, Chris, to throw the ball on third and short. Unable to come up with a first down. Now here at fourth down, you got a big decision to make. Do you kick the field goal just to add to the lead, or maybe go for this here with a chance to drop the hammer?
So a field goal attempt coming up now. And a chance here to build the lead, make it a 3-score game in the final quarter. And it's good right down the middle. And they add to their lead.
And that one, my gosh, I mean, it's almost too easy. Nice kick.
So after building this big lead, they're set to kick it off. And it's fielded. Returner trying to make something happen. Returner tackle right there. That's where we'll start the drive. The Longhorns offense takes the field. It had to settle for field goals. That won't work anymore. They got to find the end zone this time. Pressure is coming. They pressure him and sack him. He'll be tackled inside the 10.
And just like that, you squeeze the life out of this offense. That's another sack by this defense. They have been in that backfield the entire game, and a big reason why these guys are enjoying a lead.
So back to their own 9-yard line, it's second and long. Here's the snap. Quarterback looking to throw. And a short pitch and catch to the tight end. They bring him down quickly. A short pitch and catch to get a little bit closer to the marker.
I love what the defense is doing here. Sitting back, giving up some plays underneath, tackling these guys inbounds, and just keep that clock rolling.
Well, it's been tough so far to get this drive going. Now they face third and 10 from inside their own 20. What's the call going to be? Grab down the middle. It's Kelm. A big hit by the linebacker, able to knock him down.
Some really tight windows to throw into for this quarterback with the defense sitting back in zone. But he finds the curl route, and he shows you his arm strength by getting it in there.
So down by multiple possessions here. The offense will try to convert here on fourth down. Fakes the handoff, looking to throw. It's complete. That's enough for a first down. And he's in the clear down the right side. End zone ahead. No stopping him. Takes it all the way. Touchdown, Longhorns. That's the kind of execution that's built on the practice field. A very precise pitch and catch for a touchdown.
Yeah, when we were out at practice, one thing that really stood out to me about this receiver was his ability to separate with his route running ability. You could see that right there on game day and how that shows up for a touchdown.
Now the all-important extra point. PAT up and good. They get a little bit closer.
That makes the score Georgia 51, Texas 41.
The kickoff team on the field now as they get set to send this one away. He's going to return it from near the goal line. And he's tackled at the 21. That's where the drive will start. And the Bulldogs offense is back out on the field. They'd love to produce some points and build this lead, but also work on the clock here. They start the drive with a quick throw to the left side. They bring down the receiver, but that's a nice gain on that play.
This is what makes the RPO so difficult to defend if you have a quarterback who can read it. It's that old argument, which guy has the chalk last? Well, with a quarterback that can read it like that, the quarterback has the chalk last. He reads that they're up, makes the throw in the quick slant, gets some really good yards.
Makes a quick catch. He's tackled quickly, but the yardage is good enough for the first down.
And the defense sits back in his zone coverage. Good job here by the quarterback recognizing that soft coverage, and he hits the routine drag route underneath for a first down.
Fresh set of downs for the offense. First down. The shotgun handoff here. It's a two-yard gain. Second and 8 coming up.
Man, I like the run play here. And offensively, at this point in the game, you want to remain in that attack mode first while also staying in bounds and working that clock.
What's the play call here on second down for this offense? And the wideout goes in motion. Looking downfield, it's Beck. Looks to the left, pass caught. And the defense swarms, not much of a gain on that completion.
Boy, this receiver in the slot is giving this defense all kinds of problems. He has another catch on the day. You may want to adjust out, get out of your base, maybe try 5 or 6 defensive backs on the field, somebody that can match up more athletically against this slot receiver.
Out of the gun now on third down. Delivers from the pocket, complete over the middle. Not much after the catch, but it is good enough for a first down.
Well, why not, Chris? Here we are in the fourth quarter. It's third down. This guy's been making plays all game long. Go back to him again, and it works out.
This Georgia offense is moving quickly down the field. Offense moving receivers around now before the snap. On first down, it's play action. Oh, and it's incomplete. What an opportunity for a desperately needed takeaway. Couldn't quite come up with it.
from the snap of the ball, it looked like he knew exactly where he wanted to go with the football, but the guy just had him blanketed, and he still tried to get the ball squeezed in there. I think he's got to do a better job of working through his progressions to find that open man.
Little eye candy here from the offense, some pre-snap motion. Looking to throw again. Here's a screen pass to the running back. We're finally able to stop him, but the defense is fooled a bit on that screen play. It's a solid gain for a first down.
Chris, another accurate throw by this quarterback, and this guy has just been on fire all game long, over 200 yards passing, but more importantly, making great decisions for this offense and put them in a position to win this game.
He hands it off from the gun. In the clear at the 25. You make the stop, but not before a solid gain that time.
What a shock, right? I mean, this guy once again gets his hands on the football, and great things seems to happen. He's over 120 yards on the day, and it's really been a combination of his vision and speed, along with really dominant offensive line play.
Pre-snap motion from the offense. Here comes a throw from the red zone. And he's going to fling it deep, going for it all here. And it's intercepted, the last thing they could afford.
Boy, this defense did exactly what they needed to do. Come up with a turnover here in the second half to get themselves back in the game. They get the interception. Now, can their offense come up with a way to cut into this lead?
Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. Looking to throw. It's yours. Short connection to the tight end here. And he's brought down, but there is a flag on the field. Let's check out this call.
Roughing the pass. Defense.
That's just an egregious late hit. Obvious roughing the passer. First down here for this offense. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. With the catch, it's Moore. They make the tackle, but not before a solid gain on that pass.
It's a nice completion there, Chris. And this possession at this point in the game is critical for them. They've got to focus on putting points on the board right now to make this a one-possession game.
Pass complete. It's second down now. That's the wide receiver coming in motion now. Caught behind the line. It's Bond. Good enough for first down yardage.
Chris, here we are in the fourth quarter. These guys are trailing. Had been a great day, but with this quarterback, he's as gifted as anybody in the country. You never count these guys out.
First down play call. How aggressive will it be? From the shotgun, handoff inside. Defense gets him down, but they'll take the gain on that play.
I tell you, to be able to pick up a nice gain like that, those offensive linemen have to sustain their blocks. Gave him a chance at a really nice gain.
Longhorns come to the line in the hurry up. They look to throw it here on second down. He'll try a pass here. Not enough on that one. It falls incomplete.
Man, this quarterback is a stud. I looked at him all week and thought he had a chance to light up the scoreboard. But if the defense can put that kind of pressure on him, that's how you slow him down today.
After the incompletion, they'll come to the line for a third and four. To throw, it's yours. Bringing pressure. It's intercepted, threw it across his body. He's got some room and some blockers here. And he's wrapped up after a solid return.
Boy, would this quarterback love to have this one back. They're trying to work themselves back into this game here in the second half, and the defense comes up with a big turnover that could be the nail in the coffin.
And the Georgia offense is back out on the field. They had it going on the last drive, but it ended abruptly with the interception. Let's see what they can do here. And the one moves the ball up to the 33.
Man, just complimentary football, really, in a nutshell. They get this football back thanks to their own defense creating that turnover, working with the lead like this.
Really, it's all but over. Now the offense is just thinking about running the football and working that clock.
Second down after that run on the previous play. They'll work the clock here with the running game. The sophomore with a strong tackle there.
Well, this is a huge third down coming up here, and here's where that chess match comes to head. And for the defense, they desperately need to make a play if they believe they have any chance of coming back to win this game.
The defense with more pre-snap movement. And that's the two-minute warning as this offense tries to work the clock, getting closer now to an impressive victory. Big third down play. If they can't get the stop, they have to consider calling a timeout. And the tight end goes in motion before the snap. Can he get there on the ground? They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one. And now it's the defense that calls timeout here, trying to get organized and preserve as much clock as possible. The Dogs will bring their punt team onto the field. Returner is brought down. Gets a start on the next drive. First down play call coming up. How aggressive will it be? Dropping back. It's yours. Let's it go quickly. He's got an open man downfield, and it's caught. And they'll move the six on that one. It's a first down to the 42.
Boy, they love going to this guy in the slot, don't they? What a mismatch inside. He reels in another one. This guy's automatic.
Now they've got to hustle to the line and get set. And looking to throw now on first down. And now in the final couple minutes, here's a deep shot. Incomplete. They cannot connect on the deep ball.
Well, they don't connect here. But this is what you have to do. It's late in the game. You need points. You're behind. You got to take some shots. I'd go right back to it, try to find a matchup, and go to one of your receivers that can make a play for you.
Second and 10 here. Here's the snap. Quarterback drops back. The catch is made for a huge pickup. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Texas.
What a score by this offense, and the greatest thing, Chris, is they still left themselves with a little bit of time, and now you're thinking onside kick if they can recover it. You never know.
Kicking team on now for the extra point. PAT is good. They still trail, though.
That makes the score Georgia 51, Texas 48.
Looks like they're lining up to attempt an onside kick. And the receiving team has recovered. Looks like the hands team did its job. And the powerful Georgia offense is back out on the field. Crucial possession here. This game just got tighter. Three-point game, final quarter. What will the play-calling philosophy be here? Brought down, but broke a tackle to produce a solid game there. Now a timeout taken by the defense, trying to preserve as much clock as possible for their offense. Now it's second down here. They're going to run it. He stopped, but he gets a first down. And now it's the defense that calls timeout here, trying to get organized and preserve as much clock as possible.
Look, I realize on any play call, when it's properly executed, it can go to the house for a touchdown. But the runs that really make a game plan work are the ones where you get just what you need. And he barely got the first down, but he got it.